start with who you want to serve. And there's a ton of different genres, and I'll mention a link at the end where I have a deeper dive training where I kind of break down the 9 different reasons why people travel.
For you, what is it that you're looking for? Is there a rule? Do you strictly look at the numbers, or is there another kind of a specific type of property that makes the most sense for this business model?
Yeah. So the first question I always ask people is, who do you want to serve first and foremost, right? Like, who are you targeting? And for myself, especially when we get started, I wanted to attract families with kids and couples. Because in my head, I was a guy with a family, right? And I just wanted to be around people that were similar to me, selfishly. And I also knew that I would have less headaches, right? So yeah. Start with who you want to serve. And there's a ton of different genres, and I'll mention a link at the end where I have a deeper dive training where I kind of break down the 9 different reasons why people travel and who you could serve. So first is, who do you want to serve? Then the next question is do you want to be the Walmart, the Target, or the Nordstrom of your market? Right? So a lot of investors, especially when they're getting started, they focus a lot on the C-class properties because they're more affordable. They, on paper anyway, they look like they're going to cash flow better. I typically do not go for C-class properties with short-term rentals. That's just not who I serve, right? So I want to be more of that like B-plus to A-class property. Most of my multis, I would say, are in the B-class range that we have for short-term rentals. I like to be in that target, right? Like the upper target, not necessarily Nordstrom. I do have a couple Nordstrom properties that are lights out, but I like, my sweet spot for me is a 2-3 bedroom with 2 baths, because I can comfortably sleep 6 to 8 people, no problem. And with 2 bathrooms, it's not an issue with showers. Now, the next thing you want to think about is where, again, when you identify who you want to serve or who could you serve, when you're looking at where do you want to set up a property? So a lot of folks got crushed during COVID because they were only catering to one type of client, right? Whether it was a vacationer or whatever. All of our properties, actually, even our beach house in Florida did well during that time. But the majority of our properties, they're about 30 minutes outside of a major metro. So I don't operate inside of Boston. I don't operate inside of Asheville, North Carolina. I don't operate inside of, you know, any major metro. I go about 30 minutes outside. And there's a couple reasons for that. One is typically the major metros, there's a lack of housing in general. So most of them are implementing regulations to highly restrict short-term rental activity in like the proper metros themselves, right? So like Boston, it's nearly impossible to run in Boston, right? So I'll go 30 minutes outside of Boston, find a nice town with either train or easy access into the city if they want that. But then I'll also look for, you know, is there a university there? Is there a decent sized hospital there? What type of employment centers are there? How close is it to any local attractions? How close is it to a beach or some type of other activity? And when I blend all of those, or at least, you know, 3 or 4 of them, I'm attracting a lot of different traveler profiles, whether it's traveling nurses, whether it's corporate travel, whether it's families, whether it's people that are looking to relocate because of business, right? So I'm attracting a lot of, I'm diversifying my client base based on the locations that I choose.